Good morning. Let's do three Newton's second law multiple choice problems to review for the AP Physics 1 exam. This is a part of my AP Physics 1 Ultimate Review Packet, so please consider signing up at ultimatereviewpacket.com for the full review.
Flippin' Physics!
Bobby, please read question 1.
Question 1. A rock is freely falling downward toward the Earth. The weight of the rock is capital W. Which of the following best describes the force from the rock on the Earth as the rock falls? The force the rock causes on the Earth as it falls is choice A, zero, choice B, capital W upward, choice C, capital W downward, or choice D, increasing in magnitude as the rock's speed increases.
Thank you, Bobby. Bo, please solve this problem.
Sure. Well, weight and force of gravity mean the same thing, so capital W is both the weight of the rock and the force of gravity on the rock. And the force of gravity on the rock is the force from the Earth on the rock. Oh, okay, this question is testing our knowledge of Newton's third law. For every force, object 1 applies on object 2. Object 2 applies an equal but opposite force on object 1. In this problem, the two objects are the Earth and the rock, and the weight of the rock is, as I already said, the force the Earth applies on the rock, which is equal but opposite to the force the rock applies on the Earth. In other words, the force the rock causes on the Earth is equal to the downward weight of the rock, only in the opposite direction or upwards. That means the correct answer is choice B.
So this question wasn't really about Newton's second law, was it?
Huh. I guess not.
Yeah. That's weird. Okay, I guess I tricked you there? I don't know. Well done, Bo. Bobby, please read question 2.
Question 2. A 300 Newton object is accelerating to the north at 1 meter per second squared. A force 1, of 40 Newtons acts due east on the object. If there is only one other force 2, acting on the object, what is the magnitude and direction of force 2? Choice A is 50 Newtons at an angle of 37 degrees north of west. Choice B is 50 newtons at an angle of 53 degrees north of west. Choice C is 35 newtons at an angle of 37 degrees north of west. And choice D is 35 newtons at an angle of 53 degrees north of west.
Thank you, Bobby. Billy, please solve this problem.
Absolutely. Well, we know a 300 newton object has a weight of 300 newtons, so let's use that to determine the mass of the object. Force of gravity equals mass times acceleration due to gravity, so mass equals force of gravity divided by acceleration due to gravity, or 300 newtons divided by, let's use 10 meters per second squared, because that is what they recommend we use on the AP Physics exams. So we get that the mass of the object is roughly 30 kilograms. We know the acceleration of the object is directly north, so let's call north the positive y direction and identify east as the positive x direction. Because force 1 is entirely in the positive x direction, force 1 has no component in the y direction. That means the acceleration of the object is caused entirely by the y component of force 2. And that means we can find the y component of force 2 by some of the forces in the y direction. The net force in the y direction acting on the object equals force 2 in the y direction. We already determined that the only force acting on the object in the y direction is that force. And that equals mass times acceleration in the y direction. 30 kilograms times 1 meter per second squared, or 30 newtons. We also know the acceleration of the object in the x direction is 0. Therefore, the x component of force 2 must be in the negative x direction to balance out force 1. That means we can find the x component of force 2 by summing the forces in the x direction. The net force in the x direction equals the negative of force 2 in the x direction plus force 1. And the net force in the x direction also equals mass times acceleration in the x direction. However, the object is not accelerating in the x direction. So the right-hand side of the equation equals 0. Therefore, force 2 in the x direction equals force 1, which equals 40 newtons. Now that we have the components of force 2, we can determine its magnitude and direction.
We should draw the free body diagram first, though, right?
Hold up. That's weird. How did we sum the forces in the x and y directions without first drawing the free body diagram?
That is a fair question, Bo. The way this question is set up actually makes it so you use Newton's second law to determine the magnitudes and directions of the components of force 2 before you can really draw the free body diagram. It's not how we normally approach problems. However, that is not unusual for the AP physics exams. They will often try to give you problems which do not quite follow your normal patterns. They do this to test to see if you truly understand the physics.
Oh.
Right.
Ugh. Billy, draw the free body diagram and continue from here, please.
Certainly. Force 1 acts in the positive x direction. The component of force 2 in the x direction acts in the negative x direction and is equal to magnitude to force 1. The component of force 2 in the y direction acts in the positive y direction and has a magnitude 3/4 as large as force 2 in the x direction.
How do you know that?
30 over 40 is 3/4.
Oh, right.
And force 2 is the resultant vector of force 2 in the x direction and force 2 in the y direction. Now that we have a right triangle, we can use the Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, or force 2 in the x direction squared plus force 2 in the y direction squared equals force 2 squared. That means force 2 equals the square root of force 2 in the x direction squared plus force 2 in the y direction squared, or the square root of 40 squared plus 30 squared, which is, oh, it's a 3-4-5 triangle, so 50 newtons. That's the magnitude. And the angle theta to our component vector right triangle, and we can solve for it using a trig function. Let's use tangent theta equals opposite over adjacent, or force 2 in the y direction divided by force 2 in the x direction. Therefore, theta equals the inverse tangent of force 2 in the y direction divided by force 2 in the x direction, or the inverse tangent of 30 over 40, which equals...
It is a 3-4-5 triangle, so that angle is 37 degrees, and I didn't even have to use my calculator.
Nice.
That means force 2 is 50 newtons at an angle of 37 degrees north of west, which is choice A.
Well done, everybody. Be aware that the College Board does provide values of trigonometric functions for common angles on the table of information, which you will be provided on the exam. It's probably worth looking over that table of information before the exam to familiarize yourself with it. Also, notice there must be a downward force of gravity acting on the object in this problem, and therefore a counteracting upward force acting on the object as well. That upward force is probably a normal force, and the object is probably moving on a frictionless surface. All of that is ignored in the problem, which is too bad. However, you will likely see things like this on the AP physics exam. Sorry.
Okay.
I was wondering about that.
Sure. Sure you were.
I was.
Billy, please read question 3.
Yep. Question 3. Which of the following two free body diagrams could be for an object which has a constant velocity in the y direction and a constant acceleration in the x direction? And there are positive x and positive y coordinate directions with positive x to the right and positive y upward. Do you want me to describe all the free body diagram multiple choices?
No, Billy, that's fine. We can all see them. I will point out that this problem has two correct answers and you need to identify both. The last 5 of the multiple choice questions on the AP Physics 1 exam will be like this, where there are 2 correct answers and you need to correctly identify both of those answers to get full credit. So please be aware of that. Bobby, please get started solving this problem.
Okay, well, because net force equals mass times acceleration, to have a constant velocity in the y direction, the net force in the y direction must be 0. And to have a constant acceleration in the x direction, the net force in the x direction must be non-zero. So we are looking for a free body diagram which shows 0 net force in the y direction and a non-zero net force in the x direction. I guess at this point we just go through each free body diagram and see if it matches those criteria, right, Mr. P?
Sounds good, Bobby. Go ahead.
Okay. Choice A has only one force in it, and that force is in the positive x direction. That means choice A has a net force in the y direction equal to 0 and a net force in the x direction, which is non-zero. So choice A is one of the 2 correct answer choices. Choice B also has only one force in it, only that force is in the positive y direction. That means choice B has a non-zero net force in the y direction and a 0 net force in the x direction. That means choice B is an incorrect answer. Choice C I'm not sure.
Realize the grid is there to help you determine the magnitudes of the vectors and the magnitudes of the components of the vectors. For example, I have added the components of the vector which acts down and to the right. The vertical component in red is 2 grid spaces in length, down, and the horizontal component in blue is 4 grid spaces in length to the right.
Oh, I see now. The force to the left is also 4 grid spaces in length, only to the left. Let's make that also in blue. That balances out the forces in the x direction, making the net force in the x direction 0. And the force which is up is 2 grid spaces in length. Let's make that red as well, because it balances out the forces in the y direction. The net force in all directions in this case is 0. That makes choice C an incorrect answer choice. That would assume choice D is correct then. However, let's check to make sure. The y component of the force, which is down and to the right in red, is 2 grid spaces in length down, which balances out the force vector, which is 2 grid spaces in length up, which is also in red. That leaves the blue x component of the force, which acts down and to the right, and that blue x component force has no force to balance it out. In other words, choice D has a net force in the y direction equal to 0, and a net force in the x direction, which is non-zero. So choice D, as I thought, is a correct answer.
Well done, everybody. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.